and a very warm welcome to Bharata First. You're watching FRP Explains. I'm frankrausanpereira. Since you're here, please like the video, subscribe, hit the bell icon and share the video as well so that more people get to know about Bharata First. Let me also take this opportunity to inform you about Bharata First Knowledge Center, a learning experience like none other, which will transform the way you learn and prepare for your competitive exams. It has been tailor-made for your competitive exams journey, so don't miss out on it. Hundreds are already reaping the benefit of the Knowledge Center. Ensure that you don't miss out. Go to kc.bharatafirst.com and register today. Get all the details there. Right then, I'm here to talk about an IAS officer of the 2007 batch of Kerala cadre who has been in a world of trouble in the year 2021, and now an FIR has been lodged against him by the Kerala police in Ernakulam. Now, this gentleman is the managing director of the Kerala State Inland Water Navigation Corporation, and there was an MOU that was signed between the corporation and a US company earlier this year, which ran into a lot of controversy and which went into a lot of trouble, and there was a lot of political mileage that this particular issue received as well. And this happened just before the Kerala elections, and during that time a vernacular journalist, a lady, contacted the managing director. N. Prashant is his name. He's an IAS officer, and he was contacted by the journalist for a story on this controversial issue of the MOU between the Kerala State Inland Navigation Corporation and a US private company. And the deal was basically to do with the deep water trawling, and this came under a lot of controversy. So this female journalist then approached N. Prashant and asked him for some kind of information regarding this particular controversy, to which he responded and said with a smile, with a sticker basically, which was inappropriate. So then she further spoke to him on WhatsApp and explained who she was and said that she would, this is not to basically show him in bad light, but just to get a reaction on that particular story, to which he responded with an alleged obscene sticker, and which did not go down too well with the Journalist Association, who then went ahead and filed a complaint with the police. And the police then decided to take up the matter in May. It was taken up, and finally an FIR has been lodged against this person by the name N. Prashant, this IAS officer, and under section 509 of the Indian Penal Code, which deals with the modesty of a woman and also deals with several of those other aspects with regards to modesty and protection of the woman's rights. So now the FIR has been lodged against him, and he is in a world of trouble. This also brings out another issue altogether about how members of the Indian bureaucracy and members who are in responsible positions in life need to be given some training and need to be given some understanding as to how to respond in certain situations. Journalist, according to me, has not done anything wrong. She was just trying to pursue the story and try and see what exactly the issue was and get to the bottom of it. And since this gentleman was in the mix of things and was in the thick of things, a journalist is just doing his or her job just to try and get as much information about the story as possible, to try and get first-hand information about what exactly is the problem and to understand what really has gone wrong. And in such a situation, the IAS officer should have just said no comment if he did not want to comment, or should have just said that, you know, the matter is sub judice, or the matter is currently, I cannot comment on the matter currently, is what he could have said at that point in time and left it at that, rather than responding with an obscene sticker or reacting in a particular way. Because the journalist was a woman, it's become this big the issue. But even if it is a male or a man who was pursuing the story, reacting in such a way is not appropriate, and responsible members of society need to behave responsibly and act responsibly as well. In the pandemic, we've seen several such instances come to light where we've seen IPS officers and the chief minister's staff getting into a scuffle. We've seen IAS officers, you know, beating up and thrashing bystanders on the road. And so many of these issues have come to light. Yes, the pandemic has created a lot of confusion in the minds of people and created a lot of trouble. But still, as responsible members of society, we need to behave in a particular way and need to behave in a particular way, especially with women and especially with those who are going about doing their job. That is the most basic of courtesies that we can extend as professionals, and our bureaucracy really needs to become better. Police also needs to, you know, up the game really and react in a positive way whenever we are looking at any such instances or whenever they are dealing in their professional capacities. With that, it's a wrap on this edition of FRP Explains. If you like the content, please like the video, subscribe, hit the bell icon and then all notifications, and do share the content as well so that more people get to know about Bharata First. And let me also take this opportunity to remind you once again about Bharata First Knowledge Center, learning experience like none other, which will transform the way you learn. Hundreds are already reaping the benefits of the Knowledge Center, which has been tailor-made for your competitive exams journey and preparation. So don't miss out. We have a lot to offer at the Knowledge Center. So don't miss out. Go to kc.bharatafirst.com, get all the details there and register right now. That's it from me. See you again next time.